first is you're going to want to take a section of your hair and you're going to want to pin this back. Okay. So, before we really get started in it, first you're going to need a paddle brush, some hairspray, some bobby pins, and you're going to need a teasing comb and a teasing brush. Okay, so first you're going to want to section the bottom of your hair. And my hair is a little bit pre-teased already, so I'm just showing you babes, you know, how I do it. It's been pre-teased. So I'm going to take this top section and I'm going to pin it back, just for now. Oh yeah, babes, let me know about what hairsprays you guys use, because the one I have, I like it, but I wouldn't say it's the best. It's just for now until I get my sexy hair hairspray. Okay, so you pin this back and then you take the bottom section and you take some hairspray. You take your teasing comb and you just tease the hell out of it. And just tease, tease, tease. That's it. Okay. So that's this section. Then you take the next section and you just do the same thing. Then you just take this section and you do the same. And I know it looks ugly now, but with the hair scarf, we're going to hide all this. So, that top part, I said, I'm gonna take these pins down. And then we're gonna do the top. Now, mind you, it has been a little bit pre-teased, but I'm gonna go over it again and tease it a little bit more because I like the height of a bouffant. Cause last time, babes, if you see my last, my few videos down, I had a video of how to do a 1960s hair. And it's just like the same method I use. You just tease and you mold, that's it. It's just a lot of teasing. But with a bouffant, you want it like a lot of people wear the bouffants without the scarf. And you want it super duper perfect and smooth. But once you have it this way, you don't have to have it so perfect because you're gonna have the scarf hiding it. So it's just a lot of teasing. I don't have to do that much, but for you babes that's just newly teasing your hair, it is gonna be a lot of teasing. Let me see this big of a mess. And then what we do is we take it and we hairspray all of it. Okay, that we take our teasing brush and we just slowly smooth it over. And then you just take your bobby pins and you pin it back as much as you can. And you slowly just brush it back. Doesn't matter what it looks like, because you guys are going to be hiding all that. And you pin it up until it stays. You at least want it smooth at the top, but at the back and at the sides, it does not matter, huh? And sometimes you gotta put your fingers in it and make sure it's all even, at least even, so it don't look lumpy and lopsided. So after you're done brushing it back, then you want to take some hairspray. And all it is just molding. So you just want to keep molding it and get it to the shape you want it. So the more hair you have, the more bobby pins you're going to need. So me, I'm just taking more bobby pins and I'm pinning it back. Now here is the easy part. Now you want to work on your bang. Now it really depends how you want it. Me personally, sometimes I will go down this way, but what I'm gonna do this time, I'm gonna do something different. So first, I'm going to take it, then I'm going to go at the very tip I'm gonna take my finger and I'm gonna slowly roll it. And then you roll it all the way to the top. And sometimes you may have to do this over. And just take it at the very bottom and just roll it. And then once you get it to the way you want it, me, I want like a little bang. So you take and just mold it, you know, mold it to the way you like it. Then I take some bobby pins and I pin it. And mind you, this can be a little tricky, this part. Especially if you're not dealing with your real hair, this can be a little tricky because you want it to look perfect. So you just pin it. That's all it takes, is just some pinning. And then you spray. And you may want to take this little section back here, depending how nice and neat. Me, I have to kind of go back over it over and over. And just take that section and pin it. And then just, you know, mess around with it and just mold. Make sure you have a little flyaways, and like all this messy part on the sides and behind is not gonna matter because you're gonna take your headscarf. Now you can take a nylon headscarf, any scarf. You can get these from Etsy, eBay, Amazon, AliExpress. It doesn't matter as long as it's nylon. So what you're gonna do is you're going to take this top corner and you're going to take the other corner and make sure it matches up. And then after that, you're going to bend this section down. Then you're going to take it above your head. And you're going to, and sometimes you got to do this over again. So you're going to take it to the very corners, tip to tip. Then you're going to take it and you're going to take these ends tip to tip and you're going to make sure it covers everything and make sure these is even. And it doesn't get your bang. See how it covers everything up instantly? You just gotta mess around with it, make sure it's exactly the way you want it. Then you tie it. And you slowly go down. And you just mess around with it so it covers the whole back and it covers your sides. and just, you know, make it go down and make it go tight. Then you take your finger and you press down on that part where you tied it. You go over and under. Now, you can do the bun, like the bow, a couple of ways. You can make the bow either go into a poof, or you can make it just floppy down like how I have it, or you can make it just to a regular bow. So I'm taking it and I'm just making it into a cute little bow. And you just wanna mess around with it a little bit. Especially this front part. And you just want to make sure you curl this last part. Now sometimes this part can get undone, so it's just all about molding and bobby pinning it. And just so your scarves will not slip, bobby pin the sides. And bobby pin your back and your sides so it does not slip. And there you guys have it. We have a bouffant updo, pinup retro bouffant updo with a scarf and your bang in the front without all the hassle. And it's just a quick, easy, wet hairstyle that you can just go out the door with. So I hope you babes like this hairstyle, and I hope you babes like and enjoy, you know, my videos. I really work hard on them, and I'm just thankful that you guys even comment, like, and subscribe. And once again, please comment and please subscribe, because YouTube just made, they did this, I guess around February, they demonetized videos. So it was very hard for smaller YouTubers like me to get anyone to see my videos unless I just share the heck out of my videos. So if you get a chance to even look at my videos, please like and subscribe. There is more to come. And let me know in the subscription box what you guys want to see. If you guys want to see more vlogs, if you guys want to see more hair tutorials, makeup tutorials, or get ready with me's, or clothing hauls, let me know. So thank you, babe, so much for just tuning in, and I will see you soon. Bye.